About a month ago, I had posted a tutorial on how to create the robot zoom effect. That's how I called it, to create a zoom in and zoom out effects when the subject is still not moving in our shader with keyframes. Now, what about when our subject is not still, is moving? When, for example, we have a drone shot and we have a car and we want to keep it center in our frame and zoom in and zoom out, or we have a game and our athlete is moving and we want to track him and then zoom in, zoom out. This is where the FCPX Auto Zoom plugin from Pixel Film Studios is going to solve this and help us do perfect auto zooms in our videos. By the way, thanks Pixel Film Studios for sponsoring today's episode. I have placed a link for the plugin in the description of this video down below, and if you're gonna buy it, don't forget to use the coupon code EmilioPixel to get 30% off your first purchase. Now let's go in Final Cut Pro 10 and see this plugin in action. We're in the Final Cut Pro 10 interface and I have placed our first video. It's gonna be the drone shot where we're gonna create the auto zoom effect. So we will go into titles, we will go into the auto zoom, and let's drag and drop the zoom in above our video. Perfect. Now we will select this layer, and as we see here in the inspector panel, we have all the parameters and the settings that we need to adjust. First thing is to click in track editor. We're making sure that we're in the beginning of the clip. We will go into the car here. Let's make it a little bit bigger. All right. We will change the track quality to 100% and we will click on the track forward button. As soon as we finish with the tracking, we will see all the keyframes and the track points here. And by pressing or holding the Option key or Alt and click a keyframe, we can delete it individually if we want to readjust it. Now, as soon as we finish, as I said, we're clicking on the export data. And now we go here in the inspector panel and we will click on here for the auto zoom in to take place. We can select the zoom direction. We will have a zoom in and the zoom amount, how much zoom it's gonna be in our car, for example, in this situation. And as we play, we see that we have a very smooth and easy track zoom into our car. Now we can change a lot of parameters here. For example, we can add a little bit of motion blur. We can add a little bit of depth of field blur. That means that it will blur all the other element as we're zooming in. You see that? It will blur all the other things except our tracking car. Awesome. And also keep in mind that you have plenty of options to play and change within this plugin. Now let's do one more example, and this time we will use the zoom in and out from the auto zoom plugin. We will drag for the 1 second, let's say 1 second here. And we will drag it until where the fake stops. Again, we will go into the beginning. We will click in track editor. We will track the ball, track quality 100% and track forward. We will click in stop tracking and export data. We will activate the auto zoom in and out. We can change and raise a little bit the DOF blur amount and add a little bit of motion blur. And as we can see here, we will have this zoom in, fake zoom out, and we continue. Now we can change, as I said, the amount of the zoom. So let's say if we make it 300, we will see that it will zoom more. Pump fake, zoom out and out. Now, as for the length, we can either choose a different layer, the zoom 0.5 seconds or 1.5 or 2 seconds if we want to be a little bit delayed or the zoom, or we can trim it to make it faster. For example, if we trim it here, we will see that the zoom in and out is faster than before. Let's play and see. But I like it how it was in the beginning. Zoom in, zoom out, and boom. We can also add a little bit of wriggle amount. Let's say here, And if we click on the speed editor, we see that we can control how smooth our zoom in and zoom out is gonna be. We can make ease both or ease both on 50%. For example, if we make them ease both on 75% for the zoom in and the zoom out to make them 25%, it's gonna be smoother in the beginning and more boom on the zoom out. Let's turn off the speed editor on off and see how it will be. And that's it. You can mess up with the settings and the parameters to match your own style and of course match the situation of the clip that you're working into. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, don't forget to hit the like button as it helps a lot for rank this video. Let's create as more likes as possible. Also, if you have any questions, I'm waiting for them in the comment section down below. I'm Emilio Takas, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.